on, guys? It's TBNR Frags, aka Preston here, and today I'm bringing you guys my KSB Longbow Road to Gold. It's just like a little short video of how I got to gold on this weapon. I don't know if a lot of people have like gold on these snipers right now, but I just fell in love with sniping in Infinite Warfare. I don't really know what it was, I guess because it reminded me of the older Infinity Ward Call of Duties. I personally like it a lot more than the Black Ops 3 sniping, and I loved Black Ops 3 sniping. I thought it was a lot of fun, but Infinite Warfare is just so fast-paced, and it makes the sniping just epic. Like, as you guys saw from the clips at the beginning of the video, I was jumping around like crazy, doing these insane fast shots, and like, you can get some of these shots in Black Ops 3, but I do not think it's as like fun, and it just doesn't feel nearly as like satisfactory, if that makes any sense. And the KSB bolt action sniper rifle is just such a godsend. I love this gun, and I'm definitely gonna continue to use it. I want to get all the snipers up to gold so I can get diamond camo for them. This time around, I didn't get dark matter camo back on Black Ops 3, and I felt kind of bad. Like, I wanted to do it towards the end of the game, but didn't really have the time, just because it takes a long time to get every single gun and weapon and secondary to gold. Eventually, I'll get it done, but for now, I think this is gonna do. I wanna get the snipers done first, then I'll probably move over to the assault rifles and the SMGs. I'm thinking about doing like live streams on it as well, like 3-4 hour long ones on YouTube. If you guys are interested in any of that, let me know down below in the comments. I did wanna go over some of the most difficult challenges or camo challenges with the KSB. Like, for example, long shots are really difficult. Well, they were for me because I didn't know what they were. It said I had like 1 out of 20 long shots, and I was like, I have no idea how to get any additional long shots. I was like, what do I do? Like, what is a long shot? I obviously knew that I had to shoot at a long distance. I even went on the Reddit of Infinite Warfare, and nobody knew how to get the long shots. So I tested it in a custom game with my cousin to see how far you had to be, and it's pretty far. So one of the best maps I found, like, accidentally was on Frontier, the big space station map that was in beta. If you're shooting somebody and you're backed up against the wall, like in the upper middle area, and they're also in the upper middle area directly across from you, that is technically a long shot. And people always cross between there and domination. I probably wouldn't recommend Team Deathmatch because you guys know the spawns in TDM are nuts and they don't make any sense. So please do this in domination. I think you're going to have a much higher success rate of getting the longbow challenge completed. There were a couple of other difficult ones in there as well. Like, one of them was like get 160 headshots. And that one is just hard because on PC, you don't have sticky aim, right? You don't have aim assist. So on console, I think it'll be a little bit easier for you guys. But honestly, the only tip I have for that is use things like the jammer grenades, because jammer grenades actually work kind of like a concussion grenade. If you hit them very straight on, it will actually concuss them and they might go to prone or whatever, but you have a lot easier chance of, you know, getting a headshot. And once again, I think that this challenge works out better in domination because there'd be like 2 or 3 guys on a flag, chuck down like 1 or 2 jammer grenades and then pew, pew, at least get like 1 headshot other than just luck. This one really just takes a long time, but other than that, like, it's just kind of a difficult one and you just gotta use everything to the best of your ability, like jammer grenades. Cryomines really don't work as well as you think they would. You think a cryomine like would be fantastic for this, but cryomines are really finicky, I find. Like, they have to walk directly over the mine in order to get stunned, and it doesn't even like do a very good job at stunning them. So don't use the cryo mines. The Neon Tiger camo challenge is difficult too. You have to get 3 kills without dying 20 times. And one of the best ways I think to do this one is obviously to stay like a safe distance away from your opponents if you can. But it gets difficult because everybody can move so fast in Infinite Warfare. And this game feels way more fast paced than Black Ops 3. So I find that people can get on your side of the map even quicker. So play something once again kind of more objective oriented. Maybe you guys could do CTF, do like domination. I just do all my challenges in domination because I like the game mode a lot. It's personally one of my favorites. But the combat rig I would suggest using is the Synaptic combat rig. This guy is awesome because you can use the rewind payload, and it's very similar to Glitch in Black Ops 3, but even better because it rewinds your ammo and your health completely. Glitch didn't do that. Glitch just sent you back in time a little bit, but didn't actually replenish your ammo or give you health. This helps out a lot. Plus, there's 2 different traits that come with a Synaptic rig that are very, very useful. The first one that I like to use is Combat Burst, and this gives you like additional speed. And then the second one is Rushdown, and this recharges your jump faster, so you're just allowed to do more maneuverability in the air and like get more jump shots and stuff like that, which for me works really, really well because I love doing crazy jump shots whenever I'm going for these challenges. The Bengal camo challenge isn't actually difficult. It's kind of just more annoying, but it's fun at the same time. You have to use 5 attachments plus an optic in order to get this. So I, for a really long time, I was using like 4 attachments plus an optic. I didn't get it. I thought it meant like 5 attachments. No, you have these 5 attachments plus an optic. That uses every single slot in your creative class. You can't use anything but your sniper, so be prepared for this one. This one's very easy though. I finished this in like 2 games, but of course it's dependent on the player. But if you just sit someplace or even just rush around, like, you're gonna get these kills in just, at the very minimum, 5 games. Hopefully some of these tips on getting gold for the KSP longbow helped you guys and gals. If they did, make sure you leave a like down below and subscribe to the channel. Tons of more Infinite Warfare gameplay to come. I've been having so much fun with Infinite Warfare that I haven't even gone on to the Modern Warfare Remastered yet, which is a big shame because I'm the biggest fan of Call of Duty 4, but I never thought that I was actually going to enjoy Infinite Warfare, which sounds very pessimistic, but over the years, we've been let down a little bit with some of the Call of Duty releases, and this time around, the one time I didn't have hope, I'm actually really, really enjoying the game. So now I'm going to go for the other sniper rifles. Thinking about live streaming that today and tomorrow. It would be an absolute blast. Let me know down below in the comments if you would like to see that. But most importantly, have a wonderful and safe day, everybody. Thank you so much for watching my videos. And I will see you guys and gals next time.